Hello everyone, and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. In today's tutorial, we're diving into the exciting world of PowerPoint presentations, exploring the magic of morph transitions paired with action settings and mouse over animation effects. These techniques will add an interactive and dynamic touch to your slides. Don't forget to grab the presentation from the link in the video description below. Once you've downloaded and opened the presentation, navigate to the slide sorter icon in the status bar or head to the View tab on the Office ribbon and click Slide Sorter under Presentation Views. You'll now see a thumbnail view of all 6 slides in the presentation. The initial slide showcases 5 vibrant and cropped images of characters: Renji, Sora, Kato, Tusky, and Mitsui. Move to the second slide, and you'll find Renji's image in color, slightly wider than the others. The remaining 4 characters' pictures are in grayscale, shifted to the right, giving the impression that Renji's image has expanded. This pattern continues through the subsequent slides, with each main character taking the spotlight in a wider, colorful frame. Now let's head to the Transitions tab. Notice that for each of the 6 slides, we've applied the morph transition with a snappy duration of 0.50 seconds. Advanced slide is set to on mouse click, a crucial choice as we'll be leveraging action settings and mouse over to navigate between slides, avoiding the need for individual mouse clicks or timings. To quickly recap, let's start fresh with a new blank presentation. Change the layout to blank from the Home tab. Our first step is to insert the pictures. Click on the Insert tab, then select this device and browse to the location where your files are saved. Close the Designer tab for a more personalized touch, as we'll be arranging and cropping the pictures ourselves. The Designer tab offers preset designs for one-click object arrangement on the slide, but today, we're all about customizing and creating a presentation that truly stands out. As all the pictures are currently selected, to resize them while maintaining the aspect ratio, hold down the Ctrl plus Alt plus Shift keys while adjusting their size. With the pictures still selected, the next step involves arranging them in the middle and center of the slide. Head to the Picture Format tab, click the Align drop-down button, and choose Align Center to horizontally center all the pictures. Click the Align button again, selecting Align Middle to arrange them vertically in the middle of the slide. Now for cropping and arranging the pictures. Note that the crop command can't be used when multiple pictures are selected. Therefore, each picture must be cropped individually for precise and equal sizing. To ensure accuracy, head to the View tab and turn on the ruler. Right-click on the slide's empty area and add 2 vertical guides, positioning them for the desired size of each picture. Select the top picture, click the Crop button in the Picture Format tab and crop the picture area up to the left and right vertical guides. Repeat this process for each picture, using the vertical guides to maintain equal sizing. If desired, right-click on an empty area of the slide and fill it with a solid black background color. Apply the Morph Transition from the Transitions tab with a duration of 0.50 seconds, or adjust the speed later. With the first slide ready, duplicate it by right-clicking on the slide in the Thumbnails pane. The next steps involve changing the color of the Sora, Kato, Tusky, and Mitsui pictures to grayscale, as we aim to expand Renji's picture size and move the remaining pictures to the right while keeping them on screen during the slideshow. Additional cropping is needed for the second slide. Utilize vertical guides once again, reducing the distance between them. crop and decrease the size of the second, third, fourth, and fifth pictures. To expand Renji's picture, reduce the previous cropped area, expand it, and move it slightly to the right. Lastly, we only need to apply the action settings and mouse over effect to Renji's picture on the first slide. Hovering the mouse over Renji's picture will then automatically switch to the next slide, creating a seamless transition with the applied morph effect. To implement this, select Renji's picture on the first slide. Navigate to the Insert tab and click the Actions button in the Links section. Move to the Mouse Over tab, select the Hyperlink to Radio button, and choose Slide from the drop-down menu. In the Hyperlink to Slide window, select the second slide and apply the changes. Now, when you run the slideshow from the first slide, hovering the mouse over Renji's picture will smoothly transition to the second slide, showcasing all the pictures with a captivating animation courtesy of the Morph Transition. Using the same method, duplicate slides for the other characters, and adjust their sizes and positions accordingly. Note that action settings and mouse over have been applied to all pictures on all slides, allowing seamless looping between slides based on the mouse position over a particular picture. Once the hyperlinking of the slides is complete, running the slideshow enables endless looping between the pictures until you press the escape key. I hope you find this video both informative and practical. Show your appreciation by liking, sharing, and commenting. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorials. Until next time, goodbye and take care.